Hello, I am Van, Gabriel of Urantia, TaliasVan. Yes, I have three names. Spiritualism, justice to God's people, the New Jerusalem is coming. The title of this video is Weather Changes or Mind Changes. So what just happened in Kentucky? Why did this apocalyptic tornado hit right there? Instead of Hollywood or Washington D.C. or New York or Chicago, could it possibly be that the narrow religious consciousness has manifested this horrible tornado in that area? Isn't it written in Romans 8:29, King James Version? For whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. That tornado was a result of cause and effect of the lower consciousness, not a judgment from God. This tornado happened to hopefully wake them up that their fundamentalism doesn't really work, that they are not the only ones going to heaven, that they don't have to continue the crusades against the Muslims and everybody else for that matter, that the fetus is not a soul, that they should possibly begin to look to a higher revelation of truth from Jesus Christ, Master, who they say they follow, that this revelation just might be the Urantia book and the Cosmic Family volumes. Millions of them never even heard of Revelation. Also God, the fifth epical revelation, and continuing, that their beloved Jesus might have just given that revelation to the planet to bring unity to all the Christian denominations who fight with each other behind closed doors, to the religions of the world who also fight behind closed doors. Do you really think that Jesus came to this planet to die on the cross? No, he did not. He came to teach the Father of God and the brother-sisterhood of humankind. And yes, he allowed himself to be crucified. God the Father does not go against the will of man or woman. The tribulation that we are in right now, we are in the fourth year of it. Ever since the sign of the Virgin in the sky giving birth to the divine new order, or what the Christians call the new millennium coming, and what Urantia book readers call the first stage of light and life, is very soon to be upon us. According to the start of that sign, which was September 23rd, 2017, we are now in the fourth year of the tribulation, the times of the purification that the Hopis teach. And look, I'm not talking about aliens coming to attack us or the Anunnaki coming to take over humanity, and that the Anunnaki created us and that the Cosmic Federation might come and help us out on this troubled world. No. I believe it's pretty simple. Jesus Christ is the Son of God. He was born in a manger. He was crucified by the very beings he created. He resurrected 3 days later, just like he said he was going to do. If we believe that, aren't we saved? As long as we're trying to perfect ourselves in the image of his Father, who the Urantia book calls the Universal Father. But according to those Christian fundamentalists in Kentucky and all over the United States and world, we Urantia book readers aren't even saved. We aren't washed in the blood. It's so ridiculous that it's not even a laughing matter anymore. It's so ludicrous that it's painful that we are so easily condemned to an eternal hell because we don't have your doctrine of salvation, which is so far off from what Jesus really taught that it's hard to watch those fundamentalist pastors teach on salvation in their narrow-minded views, which condemn most of the peoples of this planet to hell. Does fundamentalist Christianity want to start another crusade? Or do we really want to start a civil war here in America? Come on, you pastors, what are you doing? Yeah, I think that Hollywood is going to get it. I think that Las Vegas is going to get it. I think that New York and Chicago and a lot of American cities are going to get it. But I think what God is saying right now, with the apocalyptic tornado hitting Kentucky, is that the judgment first starts in the household of God. Isn't that what the good book says? Why did those Baptist and Presbyterian and other churches in Mayfield crumble? That's right, pastors. The true church is not the building or any denomination. It's the people who love the Lord Christ. How come it took a tornado knocking down the church building to get any of you to say this simple truth in scriptures publicly? In the New Testament, in 1 Peter 4:17 to 19, it says, I'll read it to you. For the time is come. The judgment must begin at the house of God. And if it first begins at us, what shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel of God? And if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinner appear? Wherefore, let them that suffer according to the will of God commit the keeping of their souls to him in well-doing as unto a faithful creator. The children that died and the pure of heart, they felt no pain as their souls left the body before any demon of death struck them. Often, children transcend this world very young so that their parents or other relatives can stop and think of why this happened. The Lord is coming soon, and there's a new kingdom coming. This one is passing away, and the Father wants us all to be together in the real one coming. And you also condemn others who are living like Jesus said to live, in community life, breaking bread together, and having all things in common, as being a cult. You misrepresent them, the very ones that are trying to do what Christ said they should do. Are you doing it? I guess Jesus was the first caught then. By your definition, he definitely was. What does it take to wake up Americans?
Wake up, America. The enemy's already here. Inside you, the darkness of dial, manifesting the evil self-will.
So you're going to build another church building and put all of your stupid doctrines back into the church again? Another tornado will just come along and knock it down again. The Great Commission that Jesus gave his apostles was to go into all the world and baptize them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. That did not mean to go into all the world and to make them of Paul or of Peter or of Andrew, or any other person, or city, country, or religion, or modern sect, like Baptist, or Pentecostals, or fundamentalist, or non-denominationalist, or Catholics. In the New Testament, 1 Corinthians 3:4 says this, "For while one saith, I am of Paul, and another, I am of Apollos. Are you not carnal?" The true meaning of being baptized in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit is just beginning to be known now in the pre-stage of light and life at Planetary Sacred Home, where the motto is, outside the global temple that we are building as I speak, where it says, one God, one planetary family. Or, as the indigenous say, Mataki Yoyasin, we are all related. Having thousands of different Christian sects, which have thousands of doctrines within their individual sex, adds to the confusion that Earth has been in for 200,000 years since the Lucifer Rebellion. Fundamentalism doesn't look good in any religion. The New Testament came along 2,000 years ago to show that the Old Testament needed some changes. And then the Quran came along. And then the Book of Mormon came along. And then the Urantia book came along. And then the Cosmic Family volumes came along. And everyone said, there is no new revelation beyond mine. Like God went to sleep? When you go to sleep, that's called being a fundamentalist. No matter what religion you're in, you're asleep at the wheel. And we live on a planet of accidents ready then to happen because of being asleep at our own religious wheels. Now, I can't explain all these things. I just said in detail. So go ahead and condemn me. With those that have spiritual eyes to see, and spiritual ears to hear, they will understand exactly what I'm saying. true spiritual eyes and true spiritual ears, ears of love and understanding, not judgment. How possibly can I straighten out 2,000 years of man-made doctrine in 15 or 20 minutes? But I'll put my butt on the line, because I hope some of you out there get the gist of what in God's name I'm saying to you right now. When we say Merry Christmas to others this year, even though some of those fundamentalists think we shouldn't even celebrate Christmas because it's a pagan holiday. Remember this. The Urantia book says Jesus was born actually on August 21st. So go ahead and celebrate that too. Or don't celebrate anything. Or you can be the real Scrooge. But I'll celebrate it. Because when millions of people around the world celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ, who the Urantia book calls Jesus Christ Michael, and any season when people are more loving and give gifts to each other and say nice things about each other in cards and send them to other people, or greetings to one another, Merry Christmas. I don't have any problem celebrating December 25th or before that. Because when that's over, people go back to being mean to each other and judgmental to each other and basically unkind to each other. You should have no problem with saying Merry Christmas to someone this year or any other year, or are you Scrooge? So as our Lord said, peace on earth and goodwill to all men and women, not just Christians. For we truly have a planet where it should be the slogan that I'm going to put outside of the Global Temple here in Tumacacri, Arizona. One God, one planetary family. Could it really be anything else? Spiritualution, justice to God's people. The New Jerusalem is coming.